so much. We are Crimson Duo, as you probably know from the program. I am thrilled to be back here. I had a short visit last spring, performed with your wind ensemble, and I'm sure many of you know that Greg is my cousin, so we share some musical genes and all of that. And I was thrilled to be able to bring Matt Milewski along for the ride.
So happy to be here.
We have several notes about the pieces that we're going to play for you this evening. Many of them, well, actually the majority of our program was written for us. And so we're really happy to be able to share the information behind each of the pieces. The two pieces that we just played were not written for us, but the next best thing, they were actually written by my teacher's teacher. So my grand teacher, grandparent teacher, I guess. And I recently published a book speaking specifically about these two pieces. They, as you can tell, are rather challenging as far as the pedals go. And quite a bit of this program has a lot of pedaling. So if you see my skirt kind of moving, that's the reason. I thought it might be good to just give a quick demonstration about the pedals so that you can watch for them throughout the program. And then Matt will be telling you a little bit about the rest of the pieces. The pedaling, and I realize that some of you are very familiar with the harp, and some of you may not have seen a harp a lot before, because we're a rather rare instrument. But essentially, each of the strings has three different sounds or pitches. So there's seven pedals, one for each note of the scale, and each pedal moves all of the octaves. So if I move the C pedal, all of the C's, if I put it up, all of the C's are flat. Now the same string, this is the red string that I'm playing, same string, if I put it into the middle notch, then it's natural, it actually shortens the string. Same string. And then the next notch down makes it sharp. So all the same, every single string has three different pitches to it. And that's actually why they say the harp is a challenging instrument, because it can all look correct here, but if your feet aren't in the right place, you could be playing not a single note correct. that's one of the tricky things. And you'll see a lot of pedal work in the next piece as well, which I'll have Matt talk about.
So we were really lucky that we found out that there was going to be, the American Harp Society was going to offer a grant to a composer who would write a piece that was new for somebody. And I had a friend, actually, in Santa Barbara, who was doing a lot of movie composing. And you'll find a lot of similarities, sounds like a movie, in what he does. And so when we asked him if he would be interested, he was like, I would love to do it. He had never written before for the harp, so it was quite a challenge. And Jaymee spent a lot of time with him, you know, going over what the harp can and can not do. He had written orchestrally, but never solely for the harp. And so he has a couple notes he wants me to share with you, so I'm going to read them right here. It's a three-movement piece. The first one is called West is This Way. This piece is a postcard from California, land of deserts, fertile valleys, Spanish missions, and high-tech culture. Imagine a classical scene in a Western movie. You see the main character's silhouette far in the horizon, riding in your direction. You don't know the character is coming your way. You do know the character is coming your way. You just don't know what will happen next. That's the beginning of this piece. The second movement is called We're No Longer in Kansas. Ladies and gentlemen, you are up for a ride. Harmonically speaking, you will be set up, influenced, misdirected, and manipulated in a joyride of harmonic ambiguities and trickeries. Lastly, hands-on. Heavy on manual labor for the two players. Hands-on virtuosity with an upbeat mood and a good spirited tune. Modern classical showmanship with a unique musical style. We hope you enjoy this piece by Patricio da Silva.
Thank you. Thank you.